Also mal dann bin ich jetzt einmal ja und ich habe die andere die nicht zum Schaden da eine da drin die Kaza Kuzum Şenjuk isem Loja Kaza Kuzum Şenjuk isem Kordi Şüzümü Çene Tadini ma tanam chenju sem kolya shwadu simre
Good morning everyone. Today we'll continue from where we left off yesterday. Yesterday we concluded with the presentation of relative bodhicitta. Today we begin with the corresponding presentation of absolute bodhicitta.
That so the kunzub da kunzub simge tenam simge sa wa de so da mi yu twa sam da wo men ro mi ba che je kunzub ba ta ne bi che la mi we yin za ti cha ne kunzub simge sa la wa je mi ba ti chi ni tian tan ba sa na da ni lu le mi be yin za ti cha ne अनि ठन्डा सिमगेस छ नकुआर छु छाडी अरे तान्दोरा नम्जुन्जी सिमगे सादा अनि छजुक सिम सादी चोदी अनि कुजु सिमगे कुरानले खोको हाल्नु छ ठन्डा सिमगे सादी तुनी दो बेसिर अनि दिने सिमरे दिने जुसाने다들 그런 심기급에 가져봐 민다샤로 마도베 심기 엄마 저기 엄마지.
The main difference between relative and absolute bodhicitta is in their focus, or you could say object. Relative bodhicitta is focused on dharmas, things, and absolute bodhicitta is concerned with, or you could say, focused on dharmata, or the nature of things. Therefore, usually when we say to generate bodhicitta or use the term bodhicitta, we are referring to relative bodhicitta. Absolute bodhicitta really refers to the wisdom which realizes emptiness. We call it bodhicitta, but it is not something that one generates in the manner of generating relative bodhicitta.
Anadi kashu dilaya nyamsha da jetho ni nyamsha da nyamsha lezu da jetho da nyamsha lezu namba ni su yebi mre cha sa nyamsha gi kab la tuden jime go ba dang jetho gi go so de ne cha bang gi yule de xin bang ji ji namba ni yong de yores
As was the case with relative bodhicitta, the cultivation of absolute bodhicitta here is divided into two aspects, the practice of meditation and the post-meditation application. The practice of meditation here is the cultivation of a state free from fixation. The post-meditation practice is to come to recognize the unreality of potential objects of attachment and aversion.
Shoranishibdimbe Shloga Nishuzaniba Chidar Nawandi Darangasim Simni Jenny Jebet Hadan Chedarshen Sunzin Semanam Yelamichi Yasalanes Tadigi Nyamshagi Golo, Treden Zime Nyamsu Len Lenzuidi Subimbre.
The first of these, the practice of meditation on absolute bodhicitta, is described in stanza 22, which is found on the bottom of page 27 and the top of page 28, which says, "Whatever appears, all of this is one's own mind, and the mind itself has always been beyond any kind of conceptual extreme." Knowing that, it is the practice of a bodhisattva to abstain from mental engagement in reifying the attributes of perceived subject and object.
Dang ranse gi nangol samarve den den chug chug chinang chya tham ji demba da do na de ya jene ji gi dana sing gi jawa wa de ji na de ya de ara so na wa chidara ara so na wa na yin ji da tham ji rang ge sim yi ro da wa sam le Turn Because Dembar chuba, chungse ge medo nyamdu, kandan zimba mebe ngane. Ji kashu, trebe tsama, jia yila mi jeba. Trebe nangpa dobu gamba di, yawe sabo namki. Kashu, nyamsha la, ta kandar kashu ji, tuandab chanju sim nyamsu linzu sena jangdu. Yana chik tungi kumzu di dindiji maresu.
External and internal phenomena, the things that we experience or that appear to us, appear real to us, as though they exist as we experience them, independently of our experience of them. But that independent reality that we attribute to appearances is a mere superimposition of our minds, because appearances do not exist outside or beyond the experience of them. Secondly, that mind to which the things appear has always, from the very beginning, been beyond or without any kind of complexity, which means any kind of state of being, existent or non-existent. Therefore, knowing that this is the nature, both of apparent objects and of the subjective perceiver or mind, bodhisattvas do not entertain in their minds reification of the perceived attributes of objects and subjects, but rest in a state of emptiness beyond elaboration, beyond complexity. And this is how bodhisattvas practice in meditation, or cultivate in meditation, absolute bodhicitta, otherwise put, the wisdom of emptiness.
And then as you get to me, Sambo, the Shungi, Zababu, Jasa Thomas, Samu Krang, Zeshavi, the Sunshinag Nalo in Niam, the Jimmy Gingana, Yimmy Yamshachas, the Jesuare, 제장 딱 안더라 최탐지 지 가수가다 지 시 유유진기 매 최탐지 여런신 다 동반이 사나자도 저베 사마 탐지다 쳐 들으지 말아야지 다데 人心, 저제 임바 난신기 대응하려야 저베 사마지 일라 마셔버 치세 드네 진짜 다지 저베 친한기 저바 강기냥 용암해봐 냠바르 샤토 냠바르 샤베이나 다디 던담 전주스 던담 전주스는 냠바르 샤투디 그래 임바레소
In another of his writings, Gyatso Tome Zongpo, who wrote the 37 practices of the Bodhisattva, wrote, rest non-dually in the state beyond elaboration, which is instruction that comes to the same, has the same meaning as found in this stanza, which is that based on the fact that all things, all dharmas, both perceived objects and the perceiving subject or mind, are empty, which means that they are beyond elaboration, beyond any kind of ontological concept. Knowing that, one does not engage in or entertain concepts about them, such as true existence or non-existence. And that is how one cultivates absolute bodhicitta in even placement or meditation.
Tabena kaju nalolea tene jizumiti banama ta kandraji chagi chembo damba kandrasola ta kaju nalolaji chagi chembi nyamne ta jizumiti banama gyude bi chagi chembi nyamne desolia amanaska somre yile mi jibi chogor da kashi esana asadi tomba nyinchi Nasukasade energy yilichaba. Then is good, don't want yilichaba. San Andreas Namgu Yondralea, Yila Mizevas. I yila Mizevasada, don't want yilichabasade, to not to want to see on the usle. Kandaya, Tinjigata Kandra Yamne, said to Tony on the yard, the name means that he gives a dinner. 양가르 잠베 삼벽이 순대 그유 순대 나노래야 이메 곰 유메실 숨바시 가서도 병어 소마데 아주 대가르 잡을 검사는 하스 드수나라 제자 코랑 무변이 주 가르이 바디 라 마주 버체 수수이 로이베 제주 가야 마체 이민을 수업에 제주 수업주에 가야 맞지 대응하려 근데 제주를 냠으로 샤워했는데 대응하려 쇠일을 냠으로 샤워 근데 순간 제주는 대응 전담천주스는 권비추의 직보를 차대하려
Within the Kagyu tradition, one of the foremost practices is the practice of Mahamudra, which has come down from Lord Maitripa. And the particular teachings of Maitripa are often called the Amaniskara cycle, or the cycle of freedom from mental engagement. Amaniskara is explained in two ways. Sometimes it's explained as mental engagement in emptiness. More commonly, translated literally, explained as the absence of freedom from mental engagement. In either case, this refers to the authentic way to practice even placement on the absolute bodhicitta. The same point is made by Pengo Jumbo Zongpo in the lineage supplication, which we recited earlier and commonly chant. In the stanza which says, It is said that absence of distraction is the main body of meditation. To the meditator who rests in who rests freshly in whatever thought arises without contrivance or alteration, grant your blessing that meditation be free from conceptualization. What is being described here is resting without alteration, in the sense of without the imposition or superimposition of concepts such as it is this or it isn't this and so on, and remaining one-pointed in a state free from mental engagement in such concepts and relaxing in that state. And that seems to be the way to authentically cultivate absolute bodhicitta.
Tadi jela jetob do chagdang yu la denjin bunzu di sung yue bei mele je zang da nyam sha yi ge su shen nan zhang du ma zu le nyam sha qi ni ba de yong a yao ma le di ne a nyam sha ji dun ba lu qi da ka su ba jiang a zu ji tun zhe bu ji ba shi zui be meditation room ni nan zhang The shrine room, someone will come at you. Dinan or between the damaging. Yamanese will cook the latter, Yamsha sorcery. That delay are too downy, lonely. And Chawashian and Juby cup. That diggy, but it did twin some neck of Santa, jet of neck of the chili, Tishago Metro. The name is done that jet of the neck of so. Ta korang be lele jam ni semua tu, lele jam ni tu kan jadi cecah, ni amni cewa lah. Di sungguh begini.
The next stanza deals with post meditation, and specifically the post meditation of absolute bodhicitta, which is the relinquishment of imputation of reality to potential objects of attachment and aversion. Although our meditation or even placement may not be fully authentic, it may merely be concordant, still at the end of a session of practice, we eventually have to arise, leave the meditation room or shrine room, and enter the state of post-meditation, or sometimes called subsequent attainment. This is the state in which we become involved in various activities.
他这样唐不敌秋雨的电信帮秋雨的电信帮的送月饼不然这张这里啊小张你说咱别呢说了个你自孙吧移动于在菜吧那压力就已经加持起行了点不能再不能点不能没得行
The next stanza, stanza 23 on page 28, deals with the first aspect of this, how in post-meditation to relinquish or abandon fixation on the reality of potential objects of attachment. The stanza says, the pleasurable objects that we encounter, or desirable objects that we encounter, are just like the appearance of a rainbow in the summer. Although they are beautiful in appearance, they are unreal. And it is therefore the practice of a bodhisattva not to regard them as real, and thereby to relinquish craving and fixation on them.
他的移动于让给移动我现在长度让了一了贴吧等这个的于让给超过一年长度亚那就数在吧的长年吧的这些吧那说吧等这个但是对外原点一年长度 간다르 간다지베 테베이네요 유 간다지 테베이네요 샤바게 유 간다지 테베이네 다 탐지베 여두 긴장되는 이 야기 두 긴장되는 신체는 파 따살라 제도 담바지 알아데 이나 전도지 가르쳐요 지 가르쳐 님보면서 난다 가르쳐 전도 나와도 못 난다 나 난신지게 다 가르쳐 지고 제도 담바 나와 난신지게 매비 버터 드는 인류산 되는 시체네 가르쳐 지 제브르 남바이네 안텔레야 템브르마시메체 신자보아데 야외세븐남기 데네 차베유나 덴신 본주디 임바레소
A pleasant object is something that a particular person finds pleasant or agreeable. It could be a friend, it could be something nice to see, a pleasant sound, a pleasant smell or taste. All of these are potential objects of attachment. But all of these are in fact like the beautiful colors of a rainbow that we see in the summer. A rainbow is of course beautiful, but it does not exist as it appears. So therefore, it is just as we know not to crave or fixate on the transitory and really essenceless or non-existent appearance of a rainbow, it is the practice of a bodhisattva not to crave or become attached to any kind of agreeable or pleasant appearance. So this is the instruction on how in post-meditation to relinquish attachment to pleasant objects.
Dadi jalan nivadi dangwe yul denshe bongwa de sungwe yobwe mre. Ya, dungye na zon, minom dhushi da chuna denbar sungwe athang che. Teshir min dhu kien da chepe che, chubar dawa gyase la le yin.
The next stanza, stanza 24, also on page 28, corresponds with that and describes how to relinquish or abandon fixation on unpleasant appearances that might produce aversion. It says, the different kinds of suffering that we experience are like a dreaming of one of your children dying. Taking confused appearances as real is unnecessarily exhausting. Therefore, when met with adverse conditions, it is the practice of a bodhisattva to see them as delusion.
가르치 밀름도 규모도 지 아주 주변에 나와 임바 아주 지 따고야디 언제 따디 겨에서 남기 제톱도 되네 가르다지 등위를 대신 고주디 임바레소
When we encounter something that we regard as unpleasant, such as a person we think of as our enemy, or an unpleasant sound, or a feeling of misery, or see the suffering of others, and so on, it is appropriate to regard these unpleasant objects of experience as no more real than, for example, dreaming that someone you love dies. And the experience of sadness you feel during that dream. We exhaust ourselves by fixating on objects, pleasant and unpleasant, as real. So therefore, the instruction here is not to strongly identify with our projections such as this person is my enemy, but to recognize that concept, that projection, as a delusion. And this is the instruction on how to relinquish fixation on the reality of unpleasant objects.
Tandona Chuyul Denshin Pon Suinare, Tanas Dunyul Denshin Pon Suinare, then you will Nigalo, Tandona, Chigi Karuba, Chishin Sabuad, catch away with it. 가서 나왔다 탐 집에 튜브를 때네. 엔텔레비 신자 보았대. 내가 저것도 띠임이라.
In sum, in both of these cases, whether it is abandoning fixation on the reality of objects of attachment or on objects of aversion, in either case, what is important is to let go of fixation on the perceived attributes of the object.
내 누자다 조디다 삼록한테 당고 알아서 나랑 소리야 다다 지 댄댄 추추도 당 알아서 나와 있는 거요 이제 다 간다지 지 나와 잡으면 되지 있는 거요 뒤 나와디 나좀 니네스 나와 좀 니네다 댄댄 추추도 없이 아주 진디야 댄댄 추추도 없이 난디야 나의 주인이 되네 된데 나도 나한테 받는 신기 나와 지신도 지금 의변이 주의 세나장도 지금 유이 내주의라 된데 지금 나와 나 신지 열을 왜서나 그래 여마에서 지금 딜레야 남주 가르쳐 버리시나 매시 나와서는 라도 야나 심에 자데시지 되게 타니 노요래 가레스나 그런 거 저로 나와나지 유지라 당분이네 중요요 말에 당부 중요요 말에 바도 내뉴요 말에 타마는 거 가지요 말에서 제가 네 균자 되네 시자요 말에서 시자요 말에 되네 매시 나와 이나야 낭 잠시 나와 잠시 가라시 나와 잠시 가라 규겐 딘디 초발을 때네 규겐 딘디 초발을 때네 나와 잠시 가라시 다 대한 비랑 아주 TV 나노로 지 가서 다지 텔레비전 나노래야 지 송년 마음 샤디 가라 송년 아주 샤와는 신지 피게 여러분 여 말해 이내야 텐데 수년 잠시 언디가라 그래서나 딱 안들지 주제 딘제게 가르르다 지코라 주제 제에서나 탄도 딘제레야 댄체 규예 딘제 초바라 댄 나와 잠시 언디가라스 딘제 인주사 디규젠 댄에 딘제 베지 베지 뎀바르 마신 사디 삼로 땅땅으로 부디 딘제지 땅구요
Mainly the way that we need to think about this is that, of course, we experience appearances, things appear to us, but they are mere appearances. While being mere appearances, in the because they appear to us, they seem to us to be real. That is to say, as though they exist beyond or aside from or independent of their mere appearance to us or our mere experience of them. But in reality, if you ask, does what appears to me exist outside my experience of it? No. Because what appears to us has never existed. What appears to us never came into existence, does not remain in existence, and will therefore never pass out of existence. It has no basis whatsoever, other than being mere appearance. It is like, for example, the diverse images which we can see on the television screen. Those things are not really there. They do appear because they are an illusion created by, or an illusionary image created by our technology. But the things that they seem to be are not really there on or in the television. And this is how we think about the unreality or non-reality of mere appearances. We do not refute or negate mere appearances, but we question the reality that we falsely impute to appearances.
就苏水基 就是说是迷信拿到了这刚也电影电影他的那个没看见别这地被什么那边可对于呢嗯可说是了东也这吧刚也这吧的天气特别见不得了那就佛给不住见不得了人家给刚也那么就忙不用的了现在你给的昨晚这可能有点那边点点出入的那晚呢刚才可能这边先把去不去不去 电信什么什么就有印章第一军站的呢但是这个预计外的这些原来没呢所以说这个怕三个东西的团 동의기념례사데 所以呢，就什么呀？第四，这个relief什么的，那就第一次听不见什么呀？动也那么忙不，没用呀？这个第一次relief就啊，这弄过来什么程度？那现在嘛，都这个全他们这东北人的这个缺给他们的这个，嗯，他这个给这直播的些的呢，这些来偏倒了嘛是。
This has very real implications for our lives. Throughout our lives, because we fixate on the reality of perceived objects or appearances, we suffer a great deal. For example, by identifying certain objects as pleasant, such as friends, or if we're in a couple, our partner, and so on, we cause ourselves a lot of suffering through the intensity of our fixation on their supposed reality as such. Similarly, when we identify people as enemies, people who cause us problems, think of them as causes of our suffering, whom we find it hard to forgive, and so on, this fixation causes us a great deal of misery as well. In both cases, the cause here is not the attribute perceived in the pleasant or unpleasant object. It's our fixation on the falsely perceived reality of the object. In other words, these attributes are not present in the pleasant or unpleasant object. They're produced by the input that we add to the whole situation, that our minds create. And it is our own input, the creation of our own mind, that makes these concepts about people and things seem so real to us. But really, they are just the creations of our mind. Understanding this and putting this into practice is why the cultivation of emptiness is important. Otherwise, simply saying all things are inherently empty does not really do very much or help you at all. The function of the cultivation of meditation on emptiness and so forth is to reduce and eventually eradicate your fixation on the perceived reality of appearances and so on. It is that eradication of fixation that will relieve your suffering. Simply spouting highfalutin Dharma jargon will not really do you much good at all.
他的那第一节了呀，咋会对这书不对？铁大个拉不下了，拉不下的，铁大个拉不下他，工作成就是为难了，他们成就是为难了，到底给的，就拉不下了，拉不下的，他多呢，成就是不拉不下了，拉不下的。The
next section is training in the various aspects of training or guidelines of the cultivation of bodhicitta, both relative and absolute. There are five sections to this. The first of which is the practice of the six perfections.
The practices
of the six perfections are briefly described in the following six stanzas, starting with the stanza 25 on the bottom of page 28, which describes the practice of generosity, saying, if it is necessary for those who seek awakening to give away even their own bodies, then what need is there to say that external possessions must be given away also. It is therefore the practice of a bodhisattva to give generously without any hope for either payback or a pleasant karmic maturation. Stanza 26 describes the practice of moral discipline, the second paramita, by saying, if one cannot accomplish one's own good without moral discipline, then to seek to accomplish the good of others without it should be cause for laughter. It is therefore the practice of a bodhisattva to guard moral discipline without any hope for the benefit of it as higher rebirth. Stanza 27 describes the cultivation of patience, the third perfection, by saying, for a bodhisattva who seeks to accumulate the splendor of or the wealth of virtue, an aggressor or all aggressors are like discovering a precious treasure. It is therefore the practice of a bodhisattva to cultivate patience that is completely devoid of holding any grudges. And then stanza 28 concerns the practice of diligence. It says, if Shravakas and Pratyekabuddhas who seek only their own good or practice with a diligence that is like that of someone whose head has caught fire, then seeing that, a bodhisattva who seeks to become the source of, who seeks those qualities that are the source of good for everyone, will be all the more diligent. Stanza 29 describes the practice of meditative stability. Knowing that the kleshas are totally conquered by a meditation of insight that is endowed with perfect tranquility, it is the practice of bodhisattvas to cultivate a meditative stability that utterly transcends the four formless states. And then finally, stanza 30 on page 30 describes the practice of the perfection of wisdom, saying, as the five other perfections without wisdom cannot bring the achievement of perfect awakening, it is the practice of a bodhisattva to cultivate that wisdom that, endowed with means, it is free from reification of the three aspects. There's not much in any of those six stanzas that is hard to understand in terms of the words. What's hard about this is actually putting it into practice. For example, if we consider the first perfection, generosity, what is the perfection of generosity? Is it simply a giving something to another person, like giving food to someone who is hungry, or clothes to someone who is naked, or a house to someone who has no home? It's more than that. It's more than simply the external act or a manner of giving.
Don't
actual force marme ta jiko nyubarudi garasa na tongsimdir.
Really, generosity is the attitude of giving, being giving, and motivated by that attitude, actions of giving of body and or speech. But the real force, the real power behind generosity is the motivation, the mental attitude of giving.
제상 까담이 기회시니 곰바베 가르스원에서나 진베 자와 진차메발라 톡스 진베 자와데 가와토도 알았으나 진바메 진차메 차바메 진바메 된지질라 라레데 알았어.
Therefore, it was taught by the great Kadampa Geshes that what the root of generosity comes down to is a freedom from fixation and attachment, freedom from attachment.
Dāna shīngi geshe sharawe kārāsūngā rāsāna ngē kē lā tōngwē pēngwē mīgyū ngē kē lā tōngwē pēngwē mīgyū jīs zimbē nīmī jūs ngē kē rāng lī yā tōngwē kē pēngwē bā shēgī mīs zimbē nīmī shēgī mīs.
So therefore, it was said by Geshe Sharawa.
Sharawa.
By Geshe Sharawa, I am not going to speak to you of the benefits of giving, but of the flaws or the problems of fixation or attachment, because it comes down to the same thing.
Jig, you 단도 진바 당시 빈 진짜 철철로 하지. 근데지 용 제장 디균 전대네. 다다 송과 기지 샤라 근데 송과 이거 하고. 이 전화 진배 편 시험이. 전화기 진배 편에 삼았던 진바 땅 거래서. 이나 전다 도도 진바 사다 가르사나. 신지 차고 매고. 배 용수 동아치 동심지. 동심지 민주자 혼 지자야. 제자 진배 퍼르도 심바사 대 동의 셈바 전주 셈바 대주베 가르베 가르 있는 배지 배 동투야 알지 딘디지기 배 가르다 찔래야 뭐 가나야 마차버 동류야지 여배 인주산 디 진배 퍼르도 심바 차가로 받으시 뭐 탐지 진구여나 진배 퍼르도 심바 용도 말아 다지 상원로 미탐지에 집에 동거하지 잘라 뭐 탐지 진거하지 집에 버려도 집에 사야지 요아지 깔아 갑시다.
A lot of people are motivated in acts of apparent generosity, acts of giving, by their belief in the results or benefit of the generosity. They believe that if I give a one thing, I will get a one thing. If I give two things, I'll get two things, and so on. So basically, many of us, when we practice giving, it's because we're hoping for a greater benefit in the future, which means that we don't really understand the true nature of a bodhisattva's generosity, which is the absence of attachment, absence of fixation. It is true that acts of giving will cause affluence in future lives and so on. But if that is the reason why we give, then not only are we ignorant of the true nature of the perfection of generosity, the absence of attachment, but we're actually using acts of generosity to increase, further excite our attachment to acquisition. And this is why Geshe Sharava said to his disciples, "I shall not tell you about the benefits of generosity, but only about the problem caused by attachment." Because if we think about the benefits, then we will ignore the nature of generosity, which is the absence of attachment. So a bodhisattva's generosity is that bodhisattva's ability to give anything away because they are not attached to anything. It is not the practice, it is not simply giving everything away while still being attached to it.
Tādi jēnā tsūrīṃ jī pārīdhī shīmbā tā sūngā. Tsūrīṃ jī pārīdhī shīmbā tī āñjū jūñjū nāni sūmbā nā shīng. Pōngyā sāṃ nā tōpā lā tsūrīṃ pārīdhī shīmbā rī shīyās. Jēdāng, jēdāng tsūrīṃ sā rī, shēnī rī shīdāng jā pā rī, yīchirī lōg bā sūngā. Tā khāntā shēnī rī shīdāng jā pā rī, sūsū sāṃ pā tī, shēnī rī shīdāng jā pā rī bē. Do lobo chik, tene laro do return samara da chik, tene chui doboro chik. Tene chik liya da tsurim sika wa nasi. An tihi tingdo chik chanchu, gyasa chanchu sama nao ge da chik, tihi tingdo da shenpe shizye dhubara chik kukorwa. Da dikora, tene ki shenye shizye pongwa de maza re, tihi ki thaw liya, ane shenpe shizye dhubara sa chik kukorwa wa nasi.
Now, just as the essence of generosity is the mind of giving, in the same way, the essence of the second perfection, a moral discipline, is turning away from, or turning one's back on, renouncing all that is harmful to others, together with the potential basis of such harm. That is the basic form of moral discipline. In addition to that, on top of that, a bodhisattva's moral discipline must also include actively helping others, actively benefiting others.
Kanda kari ne mene karjoji tsurim zari chi gi susu gi karjo bata kashe ji tsumba yi no se tsumbu shi ji yin no no chi ne be nam gyur ji tsumbe kor mizi ji bu de le ya be karjo da ji Chalu, Karsua Daji Kora, Nam Gurta, Chalu Tibe, Yavoshuji, Chen, Devi, Minya, Tesam, Pengalas. Suzuki Yidi, Andar, Suzu Sambadi, and Karsuda, Shenu Shida Jabber, Sul, Tawashi. Labrador, Nendu Yitsurim, the Mindra, Shenu Sambi Surim Sadi, Labrador, and Daji. sambada jaba shira chade chado ko ne de gutsurum sa de lunga zuru shi lunga ga to chanju sba sa de na samba zuru ji de ko so samba zuru ji chade ya je za su ji samba di shenu shi de jaba la do be ding do de zam ji me pen ba ti ding do ane shen la ya be ji zai we samba ning ji we samba dan de ji xie tabana yue guai shi, yi xia di bao. Ma tuo bie ge, ta ga shi ji ka shu ji, gyun mei ba zam shi ge, yuan tu ya ji mei bie bra, ta ga shu da gyun da tai zam shi ge. Da ji ge, ka shu ya, nye ba mei zam shi, di di ji ge, yuan tu ya di ka la khab shi ra.
When we say that the essence of moral discipline is the mind which abandons or turns away from a wrongdoing, defined as all that is harmful to others together with the potential basis of such harm, principally this refers to the first of the three types of moral discipline of a bodhisattva, which is called the moral discipline of governance or vows or abstention from wrongdoing. When we think of this, however, it's important to understand that even this first moral discipline is not simply a matter of outward appearance. It is not enough to adopt the appearance or wear the uniform of a monastic. It is necessary that within one's mind, one has the stable intention to avoid all that is harmful to others and the basis of such. Especially if one is practicing the moral discipline of a bodhisattva, which is the perfection of moral discipline, then this one's motivation for moral discipline is of paramount importance. One might say that in the moral discipline of a shravaka, it is primarily governance of one's physical and verbal behavior that is of importance. But in the case of the moral discipline of a bodhisattva, as always with the bodhisattva path, it is one's mind, one's motivation, that is of primary importance. So in addition to a flawless moral conduct, it is necessary that the bodhisattva's motivation for their flawless moral conduct be a love and affection for other beings. A simple a freedom from flaws of conduct is not enough.
Miki ju xie yin yu sanan, lu yi sum ngak xie yin. Ta tingi di liya, ji miki, ka shuwa ya, miki wo ju yi le da lam xie yin yu sanan, ji lu ngak yi, lu yi sum da ngak xie wo di liya, miki wo xie yin. Ani yi yi sum ba di miki wo le yi lam xie yin xie yin. Ta chan ju, Susu tabe narolaya energy karuada ji ngama dumbo di chena kora kora karuwa genra ji mado ji chima di ji nyusim yoga tsamshi gi kora domba da genra ke ina chanju simba nangla ngama dumbo le da chima di di Because emphasize che nursim to share him. Tati nursim Kashuji. You're not Lamsaji, Simsin, never Savoy, when they are the chairs of being a letter, Kashuji, Kadu, Gacha, on the other. They mean you start digging and then Tigi Channel. Ta nursim, you may say the Hajangita, Andraji. Kugyurgi niju, dosu kodu kubi niju chari. Dengi bindu, dati zuhu di nam gyundi su wari. Tsurim nambar taba ji, kadami gyueshi nisa. Tsurim nambar taba saati, zuhu da lente le. Samlo madama ina, tsurim nambar taba saati yungu maresu. Dengi bindu, lente samadonga di, tsurim nambar taba. Tapi mengarah pada tingin sun, tingin biru sun di juzat itu. Nyesam juga mesah deh. Tapi justru susu yang mana jik karuah tadi, karuah 지 수수용은 파요 퇴시 된 거야지 제 마도 되지 가르쳐지 수수기 가르쳐다지 치기 넘주르고 토하네 하고 돼야지 저거 마마들이 미뉴스 디균사 되네 땅 아주 지 디퍼 언더스탠딩 지 주름사 주름이 벌지 마서 하지 띵삽선이 가서 배 어준샤디 계속 부르십니다.
When we consider the principal actions that are governed by a moral discipline, they are such as the 10 unvirtuous actions or 10 forms of wrongdoing, of which there are 3 of body, 4 of speech, and 3 of mind. Generally speaking, we distinguish between the first 7 and the latter 3 by saying that the 3 actions, unvirtuous actions of body and 4 of speech, are actions, and the 3 of mind are paths of action. Now, this is a way to understand one of the differences between the moral discipline of the pratimoksha per se and that of a bodhisattva. According to the pratimoksha per se, then if one engages in any of the 7 actions of body or speech, this is a contravention. However, the entertainment of a state of mind that constitutes one of the 3 unvirtuous paths of action of mind, such as malevolence or malice, does not constitute a contravention of the moral discipline of the pratimoksha. In contrast to that, the moral discipline of a bodhisattva places a greater emphasis on abstinence from the 3 unvirtuous actions or paths of actions of mind. For example, if a bodhisattva entertains a mental state of malice or malevolence, then this is a direct contravention of their moral discipline of a bodhisattva. Now, if you think about it, someone's mental state, whether or not they are entertaining malice or malevolence, is a hidden or private matter. It's not observable to an external observer. So therefore, it was taught by the great Kadampa masters that the principal way to maintain pure moral discipline, and especially the moral discipline of a bodhisattva, is through constantly thinking about the results of actions and making moral choices accordingly. The instruction is that without thinking about or reflecting on the results of actions, it is impossible to maintain the level of care of one's mental state and so on that will maintain that moral discipline. So therefore, the practical instruction or guidance on how to maintain this discipline is through reflection on the results of actions. This is based on a deeper understanding of what moral discipline is.
제난도는 이제 능하게 자제 아주 참참 섭섭치고 가르치는 미 통과해서 아주 섭섭치고 니네 시험기들은 섭섭치게 여만 가르쳐 수직이 통과 여만해 니네 인주산에 니네 아주 뒤 고라바지 가르쳐 밤에 병원도 당사 니네 급들은 전수 선배 내가 올래야 be kajoda lunga ga chawala poraji priorities dengo wa tele ya ji sim gi be kajoda ji digele ya priorities dengo wa ji tele ji imara.
The point of this seems to be that while we're often careful about what we do with our bodies and say with our speech, because after all people can see these things, they can observe it, we may be careless about what's going on in our mind because we feel that it's private. No one can see it, so we don't need to worry about it so much. But in the bodhisattva context, we do need to be careful about what we do with our bodies and say with our speech, we need to be even more careful about what goes on in our mind.
Taji Swebale Aji Karure 지고 난세 여와 체비입니다. 그래서 제 발에야 여와 망 치다 망 부르지 오니 여와래서
The fourth, the third perfection is patience, and there are several aspects to patience.
Today, the Sosuigi, the Saban number Sumbudigi, Muam, the Tsini. 지시로 샤방 민자민자민자 카하소소 요아레스
Because there are essentially three main aspects to patience, each of them can be said to have a different essence or fundamental nature.
진짜 세바사리 조디 가주래다지 세바 처음에 봐서 다시 진진층에 지그로 지면로 우마리 진층에 지 제가 세바 처음에 봐서 지단고 세바스 망고 좋아다 조조디다 지 처음에 봐 콘 처음에 봐 되지라 나와지 계속 차리면로
But I think the most important definition of patience, which really it covers all of the different aspects, is the one we find in Nagarjuna's Ratnavali, in which he defines patience as the absence of anger, or freedom from anger.
我也其实我恰也呢，但是控制在怎么恰了，就把这些用的，对你们就算提军在点呢，这个那么个嘛那么做，但是设备给咋话面向怎么了？托斯，把人人民把它，这是几个数把这些单了落实，把这面向谁呢？俺在这这人也别搞说，但是。 member da sana da kharso da ji ba ji kimbar bi kyung ji de ji to ne and da ji ma ge shi da me wi na an control sa de de ji nyo ra ru ji ba ji tin de war ji on de yus ra
It seems that the key to the possession of or having patience is to let go of our usual arrogance or pride. It's been taught that if you regard yourself as inferior to others or you see yourself as lowly, then by letting go of our usual arrogance, you will be more patient.
当然了，就说不啥的开心不休息的，情绪什么能够让人拿到了呗？说不啥的开心不休息的。可是嘞，啥呢？说不明白，你那搞啥都是呢？去那边钱用的啥？怕那边钱多着是。怕那边钱啥呢？那边的老百姓的用还有嘛是？那边的老百姓的买不起嘛？俺那偏老百姓的用不完的是，偏老百姓的买呢？
Patience is extremely important aspect of Bodhisattva's training because without patience we will be vengeful. We will seek to respond to the aggression of others with our own aggression. And as long as we are vengeful, we can't even begin the Mahayana, where the starting point is to respond to the aggression of others with only benefit and not reprisal. Therefore, patience is indispensable from the beginning. Nevertheless, patience is often misunderstood to be forcing oneself to put up with things or forcing oneself to do things that one cannot bear to or does not want to do. And this is not patience.
Benada mi mangbo che de bena de de lo lo nam gyu ji a da ji su su ji nam be che chen ge de ji yin za ti gyun zan de ne da ji de ji shi ga ya bo ro ji guan ji ji men shi ga ya bo ro me bi na an da ji mi zhe ji qiao ran nam be che chen ge ma be shi chen ju se mi niang le chen ge ma be shi la yuan de da mo za bo ro ji ro yin na ti ge da ka zhu ji Tendition force charge, Yoma. Tendition calling Yingamar, Penangazu Semdi, Angaju Semi, Chesna, Kyokoran, and Jugumaras, the Tendition Bear Casway, Jig, Casu make deals, somebody. Tendichi Chatter, the Kalhausha. Zozo di, the Savasadi, the Condri Benedict, Condor Chasa, Condri Nimi Temito, Condorsa, the Paji. Control side, I just came down on the other. Chosen energy, or a conjuring immediate temperatures. The Degatone, Cora Sabasadi, Cora Casuadaji, Nimi Tempertone, Cora Sabasad, Casuva, Sertuar, Chamadove, Utu Jesu, Stigi, Saldaci, Nisaman Subtot.
A lot of people. Have the feeling that the practice of patience means pretending to be a nicer person than you are or than you feel. And sometimes non-Buddhists will expect us as Buddhists to be extraordinarily nice to people all the time. And if we're not as nice as they expect or not exactly what they expect, then they'll say, well, aren't you Buddhist? Aren't you a Mahayana practitioner? Aren't you supposed to be really, really nice? The practice of patience is not simply forcing yourself to seem nice all the time. It is not forcing yourself to put up with what you can't put up with. It's not saying to yourself, I'm a Mahayana practitioner, therefore I'd better just deal with it. I'd better put up with it, whatever it is. The practice of patience starts with recognizing the problem of anger, recognizing how many problems that anger causes, and recognizing that anger in itself is dispensable, that it's not a big deal and it's not something we need. It's being able to look at your anger and say, I don't need you. I will be fine. I can function perfectly well without you, anger. And so there really are two aspects to it, because one of the things that makes it hard for us to be patients is not having enough accustomation or enough of a momentum of virtuous states of mind. The other thing that we need at the same time is a strong understanding, recognition of the problems that are caused by anger. So if you have both of these things present, on the one hand, the momentum of virtuous states of mind, and on the other hand, the recognition of how many problems anger causes, then these are the sources of patience.
Covered somewhere with the jeep in a condition of the bed of the some capture of Shaman Summer. Did it sometime though? That you go to let it go. Did it sometime though? Chesa, teaching Zel Dene, some server, control. I was able to get a lot of money. Did it chona? I will have. Mother Bay, the condescended, the country gives up a duty. Did it young as some time loose? That country gives up a sound of Manalola, and that go Gangage Teddy. That massive something it's that the injuries are digging to go.
Sometimes people think of the exercise of patience as putting a lid on it or covering things up. But to use the vernacular, I would say it's not so much putting a lid on it as letting it go. For example, when we get angry, if we recognize that we're becoming angry, that's a good thing. And then if you look at how the anger makes you feel, if you look carefully at what does it do to you, and come to understand that anger does you no good, and that you can let go of it, letting go of that anger, that is the practice of patience. Attempting to cover it up or conceal it is not patience. The fourth perfection is diligence. And again, in Nagarjuna's Ratnavali, he has a very concise definition for what we mean by diligence. It is enthusiasm for good, enthusiasm for that which is virtuous. So therefore, we need to stipulate what we mean by diligence here. It doesn't mean to be diligent in anything, such as diligent in wrongdoing. It means to be diligent, enthusiastically diligent, in what is good.
Lelo Shayan Zane, 따고 릴로 나바숨을 지샤야 말베 린주산다 자왕이 인생이 릴로를 차대요 하래 제자 그로 첸들로 동토 밤 즉 자와드네 가르로 지 되매와 진지하게 자와드로 동토 바로 종이나 다들 준주기 쳐도 이겨 봐라 해서
Now, the early Kadamba masters defined the best diligence as giving up pointless activities. And giving up pointless activities or mundane activities is actually giving up one of the three types of laziness. One type of laziness, what we could call active laziness, is the laziness which is attachment to negative actions. And so the giving up mundane or pointless actions is how to overcome the laziness which is attachment to negative actions. Diligence really depends upon the meditation on impermanence. If you take impermanence to heart, then you will both observe momentary constant changes in everything and be very much aware of your own impending death. The result of this recognition of impermanence is you will prioritize, aware that your lifespan is uncertain and that you certainly can't do everything in one life, you will choose those actions or activities that are of the greatest importance. And so it seems that the diligence and the prioritization that is the basis of diligence can only be gained through or achieved through meditation on impermanence. So, I'd better not go on too much or I'll run out of stuff to say or to cover this afternoon and tomorrow morning. A few days ago, I presented the Akshobhya empowerment, and no doubt some of you were present. And some of the things that came up or were discussed during that process are relevant to our topic now, because in a sense, Akshobhya is very much related to the perfection of patience.
Uh, 한다 지 가져다 컨트롤 미제 봐. 정말 저 이거 민주바디 민주바라고 할 건 전에 가라서나 저 컨트롤 센 민주바. 다들 이제 전에 민주바스 라고 할 건 전에 차려야라. 제가 지난 상계 소소소리야 이제 몰람 첨부 못 받아도 제가 다자가 된 바대로 지니 몰람 첨부 안 받겠다고 들이 순거래. 아니 고모 민주바지 잡아 차셔비네 몰람 첨부 못 받아요. 디나는 저 시슈르디 아니 지 심지 디니 자주마도 이바도 심지 술이야 컨트롤에 삼백개가 많이 개미 소화돼 딱 그런 몰람 되지 난 개시를 몰람 대차려. 어디 드링이 민주산에 나란 수역이 디 최다직 제고 타나야 최다직 제고 왜냐 니마직이 있네야 아주 최다직 제고도 윤자직이 있네야 용 이용이 용지 따고도 마더베 드니 최다자는 맞이나 안당 아주 가수에 참섬 파트도 깔아가버리지 어디 이내야 무엇이 라렌 따위미는 안 대점 깔아가버면 되는지 내지 어디 어디
The reason why the Buddha Akshobhya Mitrokpa is called Mitrokpa or unshakable is because when he first generated bodhicitta, among his particular aspirations, the principal one was the vow. From today onward until I achieve Buddhahood, I will never get angry at any being under any circumstances for any reason. In that way, each and every Buddha makes particular uncommon aspirations. For example, our teacher, Buddha Shakyamuni, made 500 unique aspirations. Similarly, Akshobhya made many, of which the principal one is the vow never to get angry. We need to try to emulate him. We need to try to see whether we can not get angry for one day, or for one week, or for how long. If we don't try, we won't get anywhere. And the thing about trying is that something that sounds or looks very difficult before you try it may not be as difficult as you expect when you do try it.
드니 유산디 규제되네 아주 최다 제와리 개점을 차리 아래 안에 다 대야 지금 최다 제외 걸리야 지기 다 든지시 아 망심이다 다들
Sometimes we are not we don't really know what we're capable of. We don't really know the extent of our own ability until we try.
Then after this, tomorrow afternoon we have one empowerment. Yeah, empowerment. Actually, that empowerment. Somebody told me you going to give maybe you. Somebody asked me. Actually, I don't know. Was just talk about empowerment. I'm kind of I don't know. I'm become a little bit old, and my child name is Abu Gaga. That's why I'm a little bit Gaga. I'm a little bit already a little bit Gaga. That's why I'm forgot. Yeah, somebody told me, do you going to give this Vajrasattva empowerment? I said, I don't know. Then I asked the organization, it's true that I'm going to give this Vajrasattva empowerment. That is true. They said, yes. Then I'm realized that I'm really old. The Rajasattva empowerment, maybe some there are lots of people, they want to do, want to practice, then they want to get the Rajasattva empowerment in order to do the practice. Yeah, there are two types of lineage or tradition. One from Yoga Tantric. Yoga Tantra. One is from Anuyoga Tantra. That empowerment I'm going to give, I don't know that is really it belongs to Yoga Tantra or Anuyoga Tantra, I'm not so sure. But it looks like in between. That is more safer, I would say. I'm very smart. That's why I'm saying this, in between. And that is the tradition is from Marpa Lhotse, the Kepalasam Khasa.
Three special deities.
Three special deities of Marpa. The, that is included in the Kajuganza. Yeah? That's why I think it's. But usually, lots of the our in the Kagyu tradition, sometimes lots of the Rinpoches give in the empowerment of meaning dorsim, the dorsim that from meaning tradition. But I think since people practicing the Kagyu mantra, maybe better to get the. That dorsim from Marpa tradition is more appropriate. That's why I'm trying to give that empowerment tomorrow. Hopefully, I won't forget.